Well, I did. I had the goddamnedest mess of piles that a man ever looked at. I presume you gentlemen have looked at piles, haven't you? You've been in the Navy, haven't you? Well, that's another story, though. Well, I'd been to every doctor in town, and somebody said that old Doc Schitz was the best doctor for piles. So I went up to his office, and on the way up the steps, you know, getting up there, I shoveled shit both sides of the steps with my feet. I got up to his office and sat down in a pile of shit in a chair, and old Doc Schitz came out with a long beard on and a mustache full of shit, and he was wringing it out with both hands, you know. Well, he came up to me, and after wringing shit out of his beard, he shook hands with me, and it wasn't long before I was slinging shit right back at him, you know. Well, he said kind of genial-like, now get up there on that table and turn it up to me. So I did. I knew what he meant. And he said, pull it wide open. So I did. I got hold of the cheeks on both sides, and I pulled it and pulled it and stretched it as much as I could, and two or three of them goddamn little piles jumped out, and he said, say, he said, let me put my hand up there. And he put some kind of a sock on his hand and ran it clear up there, and gentlemen, I hadn't shit for 3 days. And did he ever waller in it? Well, he pulled his hand out, he flung it around, and he said, now turn over. And I turned over, and he said, stick your tongue out. And I stuck my tongue out. So he put his hand right down my goddamn throat full of shit. Well, naturally, I threw up. I threw up all over him, shit, whiskers, table, and all. And he said, why, goddammit, you haven't got piles. You've got a weak stomach. You know, say, I'll have to tell you about the time I was an auctioneer. You know, there was a farmer down in southern Illinois that went broke. So they called me down there to sell things off for him. So I went down there, and I worked until 4 o'clock in the afternoon and sold everything out that he had, put a red tag on everything, you know. I looked all around, and I was still going strong, hadn't lost a farmer. So I saw a big pile of manure behind the barn. I said, boys, come on over here and gather around. I thought to myself, by God, I'll sell this to him. So they gathered all around. I said, now, how much am I offered for this pile of manure? And one little farmer in the back said, $1.25. Son of a bitch, $1.25 for a great big pile of manure like that. So I said, gentlemen, when I was young, I was damn good looking. And I'm going to tell you that I married one of the finest pieces of woman that you ever saw walk in skirts. And where did we go on our honeymoon? Why, gentlemen, we went out to God's own green acres where you men are fortunate enough to live. And what did we live on? The fat of the land. And we jazzed plenty, too. Well, did we? I had a continual hard-on from morning until night. Of course, the birds used to wake me. Well, my heart on first, then the birds. Well, every morning before breakfast, gentlemen, we took a little walk over the hills, and my little bride and I, you know. But one morning, she was slightly indisposed. Nothing much to worry about. You married gentlemen will understand. Not much. Just put me out of business for a while. So I walked across the meadows, and I ran across a little country lass tripping along, and it wasn't long before we were in the bushes. She was kind of cute, too. Well, I was a fast worker, and my little bride came along, and she said, John, John, what are you doing in those bushes? Not thinking, I walked out of there, and I stood facing my bride in broad daylight with my pants down. She said, John, what are you doing in those bushes? And I said, shitting, honey. I was a fast thinker. God damned, I had to. And she said, lead me to that shit. Well, gentlemen, I would have given $150,000 for one handful of shit, and this little son of a bitch offers me $1.25 for this great big pile.